The one thing that seems secure is a truth that is hard to hear in the context of a dominator culture with an obsession with the material world. And that truth is that nothing lasts. Nothing lasts. You know, your enemies will fade, your friends will fade, your fortune, your poverty, your disappointments, your dreams, everything is in the process of changing into something else. So your agony is about to be assuaged. On the other hand, your happiness is about to be destroyed. So the obligation that comes out of this realization is an obligation to the immediate moment, to this thing that I've been calling the felt moment of immediate experience. It isn't who you were or what you were or who you will be or what you will be. It's the felt moment of immediate experience. And this has been robbed from us by media and by our tendency to denigrate ourselves, to see the world in terms of the great ones, not here, whoever they are, Aristotle, Madonna, Jesus, whatever your particular bent is. The overcoming of neurosis, of unhappiness, of toxic lifestyles is the felt presence of immediate experience in the body, in the moment. And, you know, psychedelics, sexuality, gastronomy, sport, dance, these are the things which put you in the felt presence of the moment. And that's really all you ever possess. Your memories are eroding away. The futures you anticipate will mostly not come to pass. And the real richness is in the moment. And it's not necessarily some kind of be here now, feel good thing, because it doesn't always feel good, but it always feels. It is a domain of feeling. It's primary. Language is not primary. Ideology is not primary. The propagation of future and past vectors is not primary. What's primary is the felt presence of experience, and that is the source of love.